Hey there. A while back, I created a two-part video about managing storage in LumaFusion. I promised to follow up with some strategies for backing up your media. The first thing to know is that all your LumaFusion work gets saved automatically every time you touch the app. I'll hit on that toward the end. But look, you put a lot of work into your edits. We know you never want to worry about running out of space. And you should never worry about losing an edit project, even if your device breaks or goes missing. So in this video, it's all about the three biggest bang for your buck backup strategies. Number one.
This is your father speaking. If you haven't already, set up an automatic backup to an integrated cloud service like iCloud or Google Drive.
Just do it. It's going to cost you something, but for simplicity and reliability, this is a slam dunk. I'll put links in the description for some easy instructions for setting up backups with either Google One or iCloud, but it doesn't matter which cloud you choose as long as you're backing up to something. Number two.
Your next most reliable strategy is going to be to back up your devices directly to a local computer or drive where you live or work.
Depending on your devices, this can happen wirelessly or with a cable, automatically or manually, whether you're on a Mac or a Windows computer. And if you're using Android, backing up via a cable takes a few more steps, but again, easy instructions below. Now, if you're shooting much at all, plan on buying an external drive just for backups. Honestly though, no matter how you connect, the key is consistency. Set it up in a way that you'll use it regularly, at the end of each day, at the end of each shoot, at the end of each week. That way, if you're out there filming and your device fills up, you know you can get rid of some stuff so you can keep shooting. Up till now, I've been talking about backing up your whole device, but maybe you're really only concerned with what you're working on in LumaFusion. That's what matters most to us too. Number three.
We're gonna talk about surgical strike backups. That's right, it's time to deploy the LumaFusion Project Package. You'll find it in your export menu, and there are a few different ways to use it.
First, say you're running low on space. Jump into the project manager, find a project you want to keep but you won't be working on right away. Now select that project, and we're going to export it as a LumaFusion project package. We'll export it with full media. That means the complete file for every clip on your timeline will be bundled in the package. Export that, save it somewhere else, airdrop it to another computer, or send it up to the cloud. And now you can delete that project and its media from your device to save space. Okay, so you only need to save it with full media if you're going to be editing substantially again. If you know you're basically done with edits, choose trimmed media. And what that's going to do is give you a much smaller file, sometimes dramatically smaller, because LumaFusion is just saving the bits of your original media that are already on your timeline, plus a little handle at each end for fine-tuning, rather than the complete original. When you export, you can back up directly to a USB drive, or send it to another computer or up to the cloud. And once you've exported the project package and confirmed it's present in its new spot, then you can delete it from the edit device in the project manager. Don't forget to go back and delete its media via the cleanup menu and directly in your imported media folders. You got this. And that's a look at our best practices for backing up your work in LumaFusion. But before we wrap, a quick look at our new import and restore tool. This is the portal for restoring those project backups that have been made automatically. Tap on a backup to restore it. If you restore a backup of a deleted project, it may show up with missing media. In that case, go ahead and just import and restore the project package that you saved earlier. Now, I can't tell you every setting to build the perfect backup system because I don't know your devices and workflows, but I hope these best practices, along with the links I'm sharing below, will get you started on that. Let us know in the comments if this is useful for you. If you have backup tips of your own, please share them with us. Give us a like, subscribe if you're enjoying this kind of content, and as always, happy editing.